Hi, this is Sean from Xenon Supply. Today we'll be performing an HID installation on the 2011 Ford Mustang. Let's pop the hood and get started.
Today we'll be using an H13-3 Bi-Xenon Premium HID Conversion Kit with the Premium Slim Ballast Upgrade. This kit can be purchased at www.xenonsupply.com. This video tutorial is compatible with year models 2005 and up. We will be using the following tools to perform this installation: a 5/16 inch socket and socket wrench, a 13/32 inch socket, the 8 zip ties included in the kit, and optional wire cutters to clean up your wiring. The first thing we need to do is remove the old halogen bulbs. We will be showing you the removal process on the driver's side, and the removal process is the same on the passenger side. There are two bulbs in each headlight housing. The easiest to access is the parking light, and the one hardest to reach is the H13 bulb that we will be replacing. To remove the H13-3 halogen bulb, you will twist counterclockwise and gently remove the bulb from the socket. Once removed, push down on the locking clip and pull the bulb away from the headlight connector. To install your new HID bulbs, orient the bulb so the lock is facing up and the grounding strip is facing the right at 9 o'clock. When you insert the bulb, you'll be twisting clockwise to secure the bulb in the headlight housing. Line up the notches to insert the bulb fully and twist clockwise to secure. Give it a tug to make sure it's properly seated. Let's take a look at the harness we'll be using with the H13-3 Bi-Xenon HID Conversion Kit. Place the harness on the passenger side and unravel the long cable over to the driver's side. This set of wires has one connector for the ballast, a small connector for the bulb, and a ground wire that needs to be attached to the chassis. Make sure that when grounding this wire, the surface area is cleaned and directly contacting the metal surface. The harness has two grounding wires, one per side, and both will need to be grounded for the HID kit to work properly. The passenger side has the same connections, one for the ballast, one small connector for the bulb, and the grounding wire that goes to the chassis. The last two wires are the H13 connector that will plug into your factory headlight connector, and the power wire that connects back to your positive battery terminal. To connect the positive wire on the harness to the battery, first remove the cap. Remove the nut and place the ring connector on the bolt. You'll be using a 13/32 socket and socket wrench to remove the nut. Place the ring connector on the bolt and tighten the nut on top to secure it in place. Make sure to place the rubber cap back over the terminal when you are done. We will be connecting the harness ground wire on the driver's side to a bolt on the chassis using the 13/32 socket and socket wrench. You can use the bolt located next to the suspension mount on the driver's side. The passenger side installation for the harness is a similar process. Here we have the Xenon Supply Premium Slim Ballast we will be connecting on the driver's side to the HID system. The large oval 9006 style connector plugs into the female 9006 connector coming from the wiring harness. The two smaller male and female connectors from the ballast connect to the wires coming from the HID bulb. The last set of wires for the high and low beam switch coming from the HID bulb connect back to the HID harness. Now that our wires are set, we can secure the ballast to the frame of the vehicle using the included zip ties in the kit. We have chosen to use an existing hole on the side of the frame to secure the ballast. You can clip the excess from the zip ties for a cleaner look. You can hide the harness wires that run across the chassis by tucking them under the plastic covers at the front of the engine bay. The installation method on the driver's side is almost identical to the passenger side shown previous. The only connection that is different is the H13-3 connector that plugs into the stock headlight connector on the driver's side. The passenger side is not used and should be taped up to avoid water damage. The wiring harness relay can be secured to the wiring bundle next to the fuse box on the passenger side. Use the provided zip ties to secure the wiring harness in place. The premium slim ballast can be secured to the wiring bundle running along the side of the chassis. Use the supplied zip ties to secure your ballast in place. Now that the installation is complete, we can go ahead and check out these new lights. Make sure to double check all your connections before closing the hood. If you have questions or comments, please contact us at help@xenonsupply.com. You can visit www.xenonsupply.com for additional information on the kit, as well as options to purchase online or over the phone.